These two briefing notes indicate to you that ministerial advisers have come forward with matters of concern.
What were the dates of those notes?
23 July and 27 July 2018. So after Mr. Maguire had given his evidence at ICAC.
Right.
And I believe you said, I think you said in Parliament, anyone with information should come forward.
Right.
And two ministerial advisers did. So my question to you is, were you briefed about the content of these two disclosures at that time?
Absolutely not to my recollection. And I would suggest, Mr. Searle, that if there was a live investigation, it wouldn't have been appropriate for me to have been advised of the content.
So two of the documents that you have refused to look at are advices, it appears, to Mr. Reardon from DPC, which indicate that as Secretary of DPC, he had a legal obligation under Section 11 of the ICAC Act to refer both of these matters to the ICAC, and he did so very expeditiously. There's no question there. What I put to you is, you were definitely aware of one of these matters, the matter involving United World Enterprises.
I don't know what that is.
Well, I'll come to it in a
is.
Minute.
Yep.
But you were under the same legal obligation as Mr. Reardon. Why did you not disclose that matter?
I don't have a clue about the organisation you're talking about.
Okay. So in the evidence before the ICAC,
right.
A conversation was played between yourself and Mr. Maguire
right.
In September 2017,
right.
where he was telling you about his problem with United World Enterprises
right.
and about how he might have to go to China to sort the matter out.
Right.
You were asking him if he was going to come to Sydney that Sunday. He said, no, I have to sort this matter out. And he was telling you about problems with Minister Blair's office. So you were alive to the fact that he was involved in a commercial matter involving United World Enterprises. So my question to you is this. If the secretary of your department was under a legal obligation under the ICAC Act to disclose that matter when it was reported to him, you were obviously under the same obligation when Mr. Maguire told you in 2017 about this matter. Why did you not report it either at the time in 2017 or when it became public knowledge that Mr. Maguire was before the ICAC? You were on notice about that,
Mr. Searle. Mr. Searle, as I have stated to you previously, these are matters for the integrity agency. I have never been accused of any wrongdoing. There are no allegations against me. And can I state this? I'm assuming the briefing note you're referring to, which I cited about information about people participating in the inquiry, was the previous inquiry, which wasn't the current one before the ICAC. So I don't understand what you're suggesting, but I will say this. If you seriously respect and trust the integrity agency's efforts in reporting, examining, investigating matters in the public interest, let them do their work.
Premier, you knew, and this is all on the public record, you knew about all of Mr. Maguire's get-rich-quick schemes. Well, I'll give you one example. In 2014, the text message about his $5,000 commission. You knew about it. He told you about it. You congratulated him on it. How is that different to the matter he spoke about before ICAC in 2018 that caused him to resign from Parliament?
Mr. Searle,
how did you then not come forward with all the very many things you knew about his get-rich-quick schemes?
Mr. Searle, you're going over material that's already been in the public domain.
Yes, and you knew
you failed to disclose
them as you were required to do under the ICAC Act.
You had
a legal obligation to disclose, and you failed to discharge that obligation under the law. Didn't you, Premier?
You're going over old material. You're going over material that's already been in the public domain.
Well, the new material. These documents produced to the upper house that says your secretary was under a legal obligation to disclose these matters, axiomatically it must be the case that you were under the same obligation. You did not do that. You did not disclose any of these matters that you knew about. You didn't disclose about his $5,000 commission. You didn't disclose about his various other get-rich-quick schemes. You sat on your hands, even when your department acted, even when ministerial advisers in your government acted, they all acted with more probity and integrity than you. You knew more about Mr. Maguire's get-rich-quick schemes than any other person. Two advisers come forward when they know only one matter. You know of half a dozen or more, and you fail to disclose. Premier, why did you fail your obligation under the ICAC Act? Why did you fail your obligation under the ministerial disclosure?
Okay.